Good afternoon, all. CamelbackTrading.org coming to you this Wednesday afternoon, June 30th. We are looking at Window Traders Market Profile, SPY, IWM, and Triple Qs. And really, you have to just give a standing ovation to what the bulls have accomplished for this quarter, for the first half of this year, as they're up. SPY is up about, what, $55 on the year? Absolute tremendous, tremendous performance. Right now, SPY is up almost 15%. The transport's 19, Dow 13, NASDAQ 12.5, S&P 14.5. I mean, you name it. IWM's up 17%. So a tremendous, tremendous performance so far this year. Quiet day until M does what M likes to do, which is pretty much distort the profile. We go out with a price probe. We go out with an all-time high. Triple Q's hit a new regular trade now is all-time high. They still have an all-time high in the after hours, as does Russell. So far, we have not taken out M's high and SPY in a yes, so we don't have an after hours all-time high just yet. Triple Q's ends with a perfect POC. We miss a perfect POC in SPY and ES by about a penny or two. That's it. Utterly amazing how we just missed it. Volume, another big issue again, only 52 million. So the average range for this month, average volume is not going to be that good. I'll do those stats later tonight, have them for tomorrow. As far as my trading, again, my best trade came because I was aggressive in A period. We opened with an open. Amazingly, we were trading below yesterday's low pre-market, and then all of a sudden the market opens and boom, open and drive straight up. Got to a very visual area, which was right around our POC, and the afternoon rally high, I took a 100 put position of the 430 puts. Figured we'd hit a speed bump there, and boy, it hit it. I mean, I nailed it on the head, as that's as high as it got right when I bought the 100 puts and just started coming in, and that, again, by far my best trade of the day. I took another short in C period. When we took our B's high, we weren't getting a lot of tempo, took a short there on the 430s. And that paid off. The only trade I lost on was a long. Once D opened and we had singles, I'm like, okay, I'll play it from the long side. I'm out below C's low. So I got long. I bought 20. I added 30. Took some off when it went back up. I thought we'd get some kind of ebb and flow. It didn't. Got below C's low. Took it off for a loss on that trade. And then G period, I took a short. Again, against value high, we were in a little tight rotation, took a short, and that worked as it rotated back down. The trade I missed, and I upset at myself a little bit, is J. I told the room B was the lowest accepted price. Plus, it could be an afternoon pullback low. We had a wide POC. I got stubborn for a penny or two, didn't get it, and it got away from me, as you can obviously see, went up. And then K and L started pushing high, and M just exploded at the end of the day. Destinations for tomorrow. Right now, the upside, one and only one, which is today's all-time high, 428.78, unless we get an overnight all-time high. For the downside, D's high, where we probe from, 428.38. Then our 12 wide, A's high, 427.96. J's afternoon pullback low, 427.58. Lowest accepted price, and they're close together, so 427.52. Today's low, 427.18. Yesterday's low, 427.13. So the daily continues to stay up. It is one time framing up 8 days. Okay? And below that, 425.89, daily low, poor low, 425.55, daily low. Now, let's go to the charts. Again, on Friday night, I will recap all of the indices. I'm not going to do them tonight and then again on Friday. So, again, standing ovation is the bulls. 8 months, one time framing up. Came out of a four-month balance, exploded, hasn't looked back for 8 months. Weekly, up, it's one time framing up. Very tight range so far this week. Still under $3. It's under a $3 range right now. 3 days in. So a very tight range. They want to get distance away from these previous weekly highs. Maybe we'll gap higher tomorrow on another monthly gap. We still have one that's holding. which is incredible. In fact, where is it? I would have to, I'm not even sure which month it is. I have to, because on the chart, it's so hard to see. 371.88. I forget exactly where it is. Oh, there it is. It's a six tick gap from March. And then on the daily, one time framing up, 8 days. We had an inside day going until M period exploded to the upside. The Bears had every opportunity this morning to put the daily back into balance by taking out yesterday's low. They couldn't even do that. Although maybe it's for the best, because if they had taken it out and we closed the way we did, we would have had an outside day up. And they really would have been bleeding. Don't try to pick the top. Just not worth it. Right? Wait to this market to come into some kind of balance and roll over. Trade what's in front of you. Hope you had a good day trading. For those of you who only listen to the afternoon video, tomorrow's afternoon video will be later. I have to leave around 2 o'clock tomorrow for the day. So it will be a little later tomorrow afternoon's video. Have a lovely evening, and we'll speak prior to the opening tomorrow.